Hey there, and welcome to the very first Haas Undergraduate Vlogs. My name is Tia, and I'm with my beautiful friend, Juliana.
Hey guys.
She's great. and today, we are talking about the Haas perks that you get when you get into Haas, because we know that they just came out with decisions. So, to those of you who got in,
congrats. Good job.
So great. You're amazing. So yeah, we're just going to break down what you can expect, what to not expect. So hopefully this is helpful. First, we'll do some introductions. So my name is Tia. I'm a third year at Haas. I'm double majoring in business and English. I want to go into marketing in the entertainment industry. So vlogging is super fun for me. Also, I applied as a sophomore. So I've been in for Haas for like just a couple semesters.
Hey everyone, my name is Juliana. I'm actually a freshman, but I'm in Haas currently through the global management program,
which is so cool.
So basically, if you haven't heard of it, it's brand new this year. I feel super, super lucky to be in the founding class. It is a major in business administration with a concentration in global management. So we were here over the summer for 2 months, and then we were in London for our first semester. So this is my first semester back on campus.
Yay! Oh, so yeah. Glad to have you. Yeah, so back to admissions. Again, congrats if you are the new class of Haas 2021. Also, want to point out that if you're watching this and you didn't get in, you're still fine. I know it's hard to like hear from us because like, yeah, we got in, but like I know so many people and friends who either applied and didn't get in or didn't even apply and they're still pursuing major things in business, are super, super successful and getting really big internships. So this isn't like make or break moment for your entire life.
Right. And also a lot of my friends want to go into like business school, but in a graduate setting. So
yeah.
If you want to like pursue an MBA, like this has no bearing on that whatsoever, so mm-hmm. That's just also something to think about.
Yeah, but yes, switching back to if you got in, the first thing, I know it's a huge thing, especially on campus, is the Haas backpack, which is, I know, just so magical, right? I actually have mine right here, so I guess you could model it for the viewers.
Ta-da!
Wow! I personally don't see the hype around it, like I know it has a huge
just
reputation.
Just 'cause it's Haas.
Yeah. You definitely don't have to wear it, and if you do wear it, that's also fine. Mm-hmm. Like, I know that, like, it's just a big thing that people talk about for some reason, but it's just a backpack,
yeah.
You know? Like, we talk about the swag because it's, like, funny, but, like,
yeah,
it's really not a huge deal. Like, not everyone here wears a Haas backpack.
Definitely
like,
not.
There are definitely a lot of people who don't.
But also if you just want, if like you're proud of yourself for getting into Haas, which you should be.
Yes.
Definitely
hype
feel
yourself
free to
up.
Wear it.
You will get this when you first get admitted and you have your welcome day. So when you come back for the summer, they have like a welcome day right before classes start. You get to listen to the dean of the school talk about, you know, all the great stuff you get when you get into Haas. And then they're like, oh, if you look under your seats, you'll find your new backpacks. And it's like this mad rush. I felt like I was on Oprah. So that was kind of cool. That was a little exciting.
For the global management program, we have similar backpacks, mm-hmm. except when it says undergraduate program, it says global management program.
Oh, wow.
So, you know,
so
special.
Much labeling.
Obviously, we didn't have a welcome day before school, but when we were here over the summer, we had one of our, you know, like, go to London, good luck kind of things.
That's
and then,
so cool.
Yeah, it was really, really great. And then they gave us these backpacks.
Mm. So. Juliana vlogged some of her trips when she was abroad. I watched them. They are stellar. So
thank you. Go watch them
if you haven't.
Yeah, if you like travel videos, if you want to see me just having fun and not going to class. And yeah, as a freshman, some of the things that I've heard about wearing our Haas backpack have been a little bit of like a mixed review.
But they assume you're pre-Haas, right?
Yeah, so just, I guess just because the program is super, super new,
super
which
new.
I totally understand. A lot of people are like, why is she wearing a Haas backpack? What the heck? Like, who does she think she is? But
even
honestly,
though you got in.
Yeah, honestly,
legit.
If you want to and you don't care what other people think, then go for it.
Go for it.
I am so for that. Like, you know. So in addition to the backpacks, Haas also has a variety of other swag. And so we got these water bottles. And we got these after we came back from London, actually. And so they were like, it's kind of a welcome back present, which was really, really nice. Keep things cold or hot.
The quality of the swag that they give out is really good.
It's actually pretty impressive.
Yeah.
Honestly.
Like, I was impressed. Same thing with the backpack. Like, it really distributes the weight really evenly. Like, I had no idea until I, like, compared it to my other one. Yeah, I was like, oh my god, I feel like I'm carrying, like, 20 less pounds. I don't have all the swag items that we got on welcome day in the backpack because they, like, stuffed them. If I remember correctly, there was, like, a pen that says Berkeley Haas on it. Laptop stickers that like have, you know,
the that's nice. We didn't get that.
Yeah. Oh, we got a free book. It was written by one of the professors who teaches here, Professor Crystal Thomas.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
We got that too. Office Hours, I think it was.
Yes.
Yeah.
From School to World Rule. Besides the physical swag, there are also a lot of really great perks that you get from being in the program. The campus in general at Haas is really
high quality. Nice.
A lot of people, whether they're Haas or not, say like it's a totally different world when they step up here. It's kind of secluded. It's like up a mini hill.
All the buildings are like super new, eco-friendly.
Yeah.
Like there's Cafe Think that has the best food. It has such good food.
Yeah. Also, we have free printing.
Mm-hmm.
We have an undergraduate lounge. It's in the Bank of America, like central building. So you have free computer access.
And the study rooms that you can go into are also really nice. I know a lot of times, I mean, over the summer, obviously wasn't as bad because there weren't as many people on campus. But now that everyone's back on campus all together, I've realized, wow, like Moffitt is so crowded all the time.
Oh, yeah.
But if you just walk like 10 minutes to Haas, it's a lot less crowded. It's a lot more chill.
And in Cho, which is where we're in right now, only Haas students can book these kinds of study rooms. So again, there's just a lot less people who are using them. So you just have better possibilities of using it for access. Your alumni network, ooh, so good. I mean, UC Berkeley alumni network is already really strong, but like concentrating that more to like Haas specifically, you just get such good responses when you're on LinkedIn or recruiting for internships, like all that important stuff. It's just really nice.
Yeah, even as a freshman, the response to, oh my gosh, like we're in Haas has been really, really great. When we were in London, a couple of us organized like a Haas alumni meetup. So we organized an alumni panel. They came and talked to us. And actually, I love the fact that Haas is basically everywhere around the world.
Yeah,
and so yeah, they had a lot of insight to tell us, like a lot of wisdom definitely. And even as freshmen, I didn't feel like that we were being treated as, you know, like children. Like I feel like they're very much like respecting where we came from and also like where we wanted to go. When we were in London as well, we visited Goldman Sachs, which was really, really cool. And this alum Cliff, his story is crazy because he basically just graduated from Haas and worked at Goldman for like 40 straight years.
40?
So he's been there like ever since he graduated. Yeah. And he was just super, super inspiring to like hear about and like talk to. And his story was really cool. It was nice to get like an insider tour of Goldman Sachs London. Like we were walking in the building, we're like, oh my god, this is so bougie. Like what? Like,
god.
It's so crazy.
Yes. I can imagine. That sounds super cool.
Yeah.
Oh, also we have really good advisors. Because once again, it's just a smaller amount of students that they serve, so you just get a lot more one-on-one help. Maybe some of you who are pre-Haas or have been pre-Haas have already used this. Like I know they have drop-in advising for pre-Haas people too, but then also once you get in, like they help you so much with planning your classes, and if you're double majoring like I am, doing a simultaneous degree, they help a lot with that.
Yeah, and then if you're in the global management program, our advisor is Renee, and Renee, if you're watching this, you're awesome. She's so kind and literally really, really just straight, like really helpful. Yeah, she really made an effort to reach out to like each and every one of us and kind of went through like our four-year plans. And then also over the summer, we were introduced to the Haas undergrad staff, which was really, really nice. So if you're like me and you came from a high school that didn't really offer that many business specific classes and coming to Berkeley, you're taking like UGBA 10, UGBA whatever, and you're kind of struggling, then there are a lot of resources classes. Yeah. And Haas tutoring is separate from the regular tutoring.
Totally. I went into the peer tutoring a lot last semester when I was taking 102A and 103, which is accounting and finance. Stella and Ray, if you're watching this, you are lifesavers. Thank you so much for saving my grade. Okay, so now we want to switch into what you don't necessarily get into if you get into Haas, because believe it or not, it doesn't just like magically make mm-hmm. your life, you know? One thing I've noticed is like, it doesn't automatically give you a job or an internship. Like, it doesn't just hand you one. You still have to show up to those recruiting events. You're still competing with everyone who, you know, go here or are majoring in something else in Berkeley or go to other schools, you know, like completely other colleges. So you definitely still need to have that like Berkeley grind, Berkeley ambition, and just go out there, make those connections. Haas has a great alumni network, as you mentioned.
Business classes are maybe a little bit easier in the sense that there aren't like a ton of labs that you have to do.
Right.
Or yeah. I don't know.
Coding.
I mean, I guess you do have to do reading, but not as much as you would in like an English or like history major or anything like that. But I think that you probably make up for that time by the time that you have to spend recruiting, you know, or like at recruiting events, and then like applying for internships and networking.
Haas also has a curve for all of its classes. So even if everyone technically gets an A, like if everyone gets over 90%, like you could still get a B, C, whatever, because they're gonna curve it upward. So yeah, I've heard for like some classes, it just gets really like, mega competitive just because you're trying to beat the curve. So that can sometimes be challenging. Yeah, the grind doesn't stop, basically, is what I'm trying to say. Well, thank you so much again for watching. This is our very first like vlog video, so it's still in the works, but I had so much fun filming with Juliana.
Thank you for having me.
Yes! Oh, can't wait to have you again in the future.
Oh, I'd love to.
Make sure you like, comment, subscribe, all that stuff. And if you haven't if you haven't checked out the actual blog, because we write like actual articles too, make sure you check that out. We do Humans of Haas highlights where we're actually interviewing Haas students and getting their perspectives, and then doing our own personal like narrative articles about life in the business school and that kind of stuff. So it's really exciting. Love the whole team out there. They've been so great.
There are some technical blog posts too if you're into that.
Yeah,
a little bit on the more like technical businessy side, logistical wise. And then also for my travel vlogs that I mentioned earlier, they kind of came with like an itinerary. So if you wanted to kind of learn a little bit more about like what exactly I did in those countries, and I don't know, if you're just wondering like what cafe should I eat in Amsterdam, like
that's important.
I got you.
You're such an overachiever. It's great. I love it. Well, thank you so much again. Hopefully we'll see you all very soon, but thank you.
Thanks, guys.
Bye.
See you next time.